Michelle Nagenturf. I am a fifth grader at Voris CLC. As part of our Women History Month, we are doing a series of interviews with notable educators and community leaders. My guest today is Mrs. Linda Tucci Teodosio. She is a judge at the Summit County Juvenile Court in Akron, Ohio. Judge Teodosio has been recognized for her unique programs such as Restore Court, Crossroads Program, and Family Resource Center, and New Paths Probation, to name a few. She has received numerous awards for her service as a judge. Judge Teodosio, I want to welcome you today.
Thank you. I'm really happy to be here today and to participate in this program for Women's History Month.
And I have a few questions for you. Who is a person that we may not have heard of who has inspired you?
Now, this is really an important question to know somebody who's inspired me that most people maybe have not heard of. When I was a young lawyer, or actually still in law school, I had the opportunity to go down to the courthouse with one of my professors to work on a case. It was my first time ever trying a case before a court, and I did so as an intern. And the case that I had to try was before a judge whose name was Mary Cassiopo. Judge Cassiopo was a local judge. She lived in Cuyahoga Falls. And I had never met her before in my entire life. And I tried my case. And when it was over, she said to me that I had to stay and that everyone else could leave. As you might imagine, I was a little bit nervous and a little bit afraid that maybe I had messed something up. But no, she stopped me to tell me that I would be a fine lawyer someday, that she could tell I was very well prepared, that she was impressed with how well I did my work. And that meant a lot to me as a young lawyer, that someone would take the time from their busy schedule, especially someone so important, to encourage me to do better and to do well. I became very close friends with her over the years. And when I was elected judge the first time, she actually swore me in. What was so inspiring about her was the fact that she encouraged me, number one, but number two, that she went to law school at a time that I think those of us that are around now can hardly believe. Her first day of law school, her professor told her that women didn't belong in the law and that he would make sure that she failed and that she would never become a lawyer. And she went on to be an appellate judge. So number one, she inspired me because she really had a tough battle to fight, and she made it easier for you and me to meet our dreams and do the things that we want to do. And number two, she never forgot what it was like to be starting out and took the time to encourage others. And her encouragement always remains in my mind, and I try to always take the time to encourage others too as a result of that experience.
Thank you very much. What adversity have you overcome that has made you the leader that you are today?
You know, when you think about adversity, that's kind of a tough thing to talk about because I think we all have our personal challenges. By the time I started to practice law and become involved in the legal profession, women were much more accepted than they were at the time that my good friend, Judge Mary Cassiopo, started out in the 30s. But, you know, I still found it difficult to learn my way around the courtroom because I had never even known a lawyer before I went to law school. So I had to become familiar with the new system. And to be honest, I was always kind of a shy person. And so it was hard for me to overcome my shyness and gain the self-confidence to do well. I think that it's really important that as women, we recognize that we have a place in the system, and that we work on our self-confidence so that we can do the things that we need to do. Fortunately for me, the Akron community is very supportive of young lawyers. And so I found myself being able to learn and grow as I started off in the profession. But being unfamiliar with it and never having known a lawyer before and having had a shy streak at that time, those were some things I had to overcome by practice and by continuing to work hard to overcome those things.
Thank you for sharing. What is the best way for our students to celebrate Women's History Month?
So I thought a lot about what students could do to celebrate Women's History Month. And I thought that something that we could do here in our area is to really think about some of the well-known women that have come from the Akron, Ohio area, or who have contact or have some kind of connection with Akron, that have really made a major impact, not only in our community, but in our state and in our nation. To look at such people as Sojourner Truth, who was an abolitionist during the times of slavery, who gave a remarkable speech right here in Akron, Ohio. To think about Judith Resnick, who went to the Akron Public Schools and became a world famous astronaut. To think about Chief Justice Maureen O'Connor, who is the first female Chief Justice of the Ohio Supreme Court, who started her legal career here in Akron, Ohio, and was a judge and prosecutor in Akron before she became Lieutenant Governor and later the Chief Justice. I did some checking online, and I was amazed by the number of women from our area that have had just a huge impact on our country and our nation. They range anywhere from the leaders I just spoke of to musicians such as Ruby Nash, who was part of the popular group Ruby and the Romantics, to Chrissy Hine from the Pretenders, who is well known to people of my generation. But I did some other looking. There was Rita Dove, who was a poet, who was very well known nationwide. Carol Heiss, who was a figure skater, which is something really exciting to think about during the Olympics now. She had ties to Akron, and she was an Olympic gold medalist and a five-time world champion. So we have so many women who have achieved such great heights in their professional life, whether it be in politics, in the law, in music, in poetry, in athletics, in science, that come from our very area, that I think it's really important to celebrate them, because they can continue to inspire us and let us know that we can achieve anything we want to, even though we're right here in Akron, Ohio.
Excellent answer. Thank you so much for your contributions to our school, neighborhood, and community. Once again, this is Olive McIntyre from Voris CLC.